Hi, welcome to the introduction to the Google Maps API tutorial. My name is Mano Marks. I'm a developer advocate on the Google Maps team. In this tutorial, I will teach you the basics of using the Google Maps API in your web applications. To fully take advantage of the content in this presentation, you should have a basic understanding of JavaScript and HTML and access to a text editor. In this tutorial, you'll be constructing a map that has these basic features: a basic map, a map marker, which when clicked has an info window pop-up, an autocomplete form, and current weather forecasts. We've set up a site to walk you through each of these steps. Go to this URL for the tutorial. Okay, so you see this URL, click on your first map. You'll see there's some instructions on the left and some code on the right. Click on the HTML tag on the right here, and you'll see that we have a script tag with a source attribute. This script tag loads the Google Maps API JavaScript loader. You see that the loader adds a sensor parameter, which in turn takes a value of true or false. Now, one of the most common Maps API mistakes is to not set this parameter correctly. Developers often leave it off or leave it with the value true or false, which is one big string value, which is in some of the documentation. Unless your application is getting location information from your device, say a GPS on a phone or HTML5 geolocation from your browser, use false. Otherwise, use true. Once it's set, you don't have to worry about it. It doesn't impact your application one way or another. It's a tracking mechanism for us. Next, you see that there's a development with the idea of map. This is where our JavaScript will place the map once it's loaded. Okay, let's add in a basic map. Click over to the JavaScript tab. It has all the code that you need. First, create an options object, in this case, map options. You have to select at least three options: zoom, center, and the map type. Your basic map type options are roadmap, terrain, or satellite. Then create a new Google Maps map object and pass the map div and the options object. There, you should have a map, right? Actually, if you click run, you'll see that nothing happens. This brings us to the second most common mistake in Maps API applications: failure to properly set the CSS for your page. Click on the CSS tab and remove the slashes before the line that says pound map. Then hit run again. You'll see that it now works. And we have this nice map. Okay. So now click the next button on the tutorial. All right, so now let's add a marker to the map. A map marker is a familiar sight on maps. You've probably seen this red marker on many websites. To add a basic marker, add a few lines of code after you've created the map. First, create another options object, in this case, marker options, and add a position option that uses the Google Maps lat long object. This should create a lat long object, which we used in the first bit of code for the center of the map. This is a basic building block of the Maps API. Each lat long object has a latitude and longitude property. Next, you create a marker object. Finally, add it to the map by running set map, and then you click run. You should see the map now has a marker on it. Let's move on to the next section. Here we're going to create a info window and attach it to the marker. An info window is an overlay like the marker object, but is used to display information in plain text or HTML. I'm going to modify your code a bit here. Create another options object. So here you see info window options. And you're given a content property, which you're going to assign some basic text. Next, create the info window object. Finally, we're going to add an event listener, which will cause the info window to open when you click on the map. To do this, just use google.maps.event.addListener, pass in the object to be listened to, in this case, the marker, the type of event, in this case, a click, and a function which executes when the event is triggered. In this case, the info window opens on the marker and the map. Okay, now click Run. You should see a map that looks like this, and when you click on the marker, the info window opens. Click on the Next button to move to the next section. Now we're going to add in autocomplete to your map. Autocomplete is part of the Places library of the Google Maps API, which lets you take advantage of Google's data store of tens of millions of places around the world. A place is anything from an address to a landmark, a restaurant, a place of worship, or a government building. We have, in fact, over 125 different categories of places. Autocomplete lets you put one input box on your page, and users can type in their requests. In real time, as they're typing, Google will then try to match their requests. Let's take a look at the code. First thing we need to change is the HTML. We need to add in an input element with type text and an ID, in this case, autocomplete. Click on the HTML tab to see this. Notice too that we added in a libraries parameter to the JavaScript loader. This one is libraries equals places. Google Maps API libraries are integrated libraries with the Maps API code, but they are loaded separately and only when needed. Okay, click on back over to the JavaScript tab. You're going to create an options object. In this case, we're just going to limit the type of responses to establishments. So here we have AC options, and then you see types establishments. Establishments are not geocodable addresses, but they're basically places of business. So cafes, restaurants, whatever, shopping malls. Next, you create the autocomplete object itself and pass in the autocomplete elements. And then we bind that autocomplete object to the map. That means it will just show results that are within the current bounds of the map. Finally, we're going to create a listener, an event listener, on the autocomplete object. And this basically just listens for changes in the selection. It then places a marker on the map and opens an info window with the name of the place. All right, so now click Run. And you'll see here that there is a map. And as I type in SF, you'll see San Francisco related places showing up. So I'm going to click one and clicking in SFO, which is the airport, and you'll see it opens up a pop-up with the name. All right, let's click over to the next section. And lastly, we're going to add a weather layer to your application. There's a number of different layer types available to you in the Google Maps API, including Panoramio, KML layers, traffic, bicycling, and more. Most of them take only a few lines of code to add to a map. So first off, we just create the weather layer object and pass it a new options object. In this case, we're setting the temperature unit type to Fahrenheit. This is North America, but you can also do Celsius. Then we are going to set the weather layer to the map, weatherlayer.setMap. Then we are going to finally create a cloud layer and set that on the map. And you click Run, and you'll see that you have basic weather showing up. And if I clicked on one, I'll get a forecast for that particular point. You don't see any clouds because currently it's not cloudy in San Francisco, so I'm going to just zoom out, and then you see there are actually clouds there. So this this weather layer produces weather that is forecasts that are available up to 15 minutes ago, and then clouds that are within the last 3 hours. Okay, so now you have up and running basic Google Maps API applications, and you're good to go. If you want any more information on the Google Maps API, check out the documentation on developers.google.com/maps. Thank you very much.